sunscreen. If you're eating chicken, watch out for little bones. And don't go swimming right after you eat.
Oh.
And enjoy the beauty of nature!
Dance! Move! Do! Match lips and eyebrows! Communicating can sometimes feel painful when coupled with facial reaction. No signs of aging, faces without wrinkles express something on their own. Get! Move! Do! Much lips and eyebrows!
Oh, it starts tomorrow at noon. Let's meet at the cafe at 11.
The New Intestinal Horror Film Festival. Well, as long as there's lots of popcorn, it should be fine. Ouch!
Here's a letter for you, Sunshine. I accidentally opened it. I almost didn't see it had your name on it.
Selective vision. Many mothers suffer from it. I know my dear mother is afflicted as well.
You've been offered a job as a camp counselor at Camp Woodsy Kitty Friends!
Hey,
but
Annette's gonna be working there too. She's teaching an art workshop.
But I never filled out an application.
I'm just bursting with pride that my Sunshine took such a positive initiative!
Is this your doing?
No, not me, pal of mine. If you ask me, this is destiny.
Right, of course. Well then, I guess I'd better start packing my things.
You won't forget to pack enough fresh undies, will you?
Stop calling them undies. It bugs me!
Oh man, who am I gonna go to the Intestinal Horror Film Festival with now?
How about moi? I may find horror horrific, but I have a certain interest in intestines.
Fred, I presume. Hello.
And I'm Carol. I'm Sunshine's mom. You were very wise to hire him. He has oodles of babysitting experience from looking after his little brother. Have fun, my sunshine!
On your CV, it says that you have a lot more experience than that. Huh? I guess I should keep an eye on you.
Well, I'm not 8 years old.
Oh, I almost forgot! If you're lost in the forest, stay where you are and wait for help. Don't forget to put on your bug repellent. Some mosquitoes carry deadly diseases. And don't eat too many marshmallows before going to bed. Have fun, my sunshine!
Dear Fabienne, I know I can never replace Annette in your eyes.
Insightful.
But please allow me to communicate. I think you'll find this a lively subject. I was wondering if two people enjoy the same type of mustard, is that conducive to longevity as a couple?
You know, I've actually never asked myself that question.
Even so, these are precisely the kinds of things that can have an impact on a relationship. Take my Uncle Laszlo. His wife detested anchovies and he loved them. Put them on everything. It completely destroyed his marriage.
Didn't you tell me he was married for 58 years?
An ordeal, Fabienne. It was an ordeal.
Finally, Fred will be our head storyteller. He will sing on command, tell stories on command, fairy tales on command, and legends on command.
Good thing I'm not that spontaneous.
And a little joke that's not too dirty from time to time can add some spice to the life of the camp. Oh boy, the leader of the canoe trip is running late. Our little woodsy kitty friends are here. Well, hello there, little friends. Here are your counselors, Nicholas, Sunny, Annette, and Fred, your new storyteller.
I know him. He's my big brother's bosom buddy.
Gabriel Gordon, isn't it?
No.
Guilford Jeffrey?
Mm-mm.
Gontran Garrison.
Hell no, you post-pubescent peon! It's Gaston George!
And I'm Matthew. I only come here for the gory ghost stories, so they better be good, bucko!
Hi, everyone!
Fanny! Good to see you!
This is Miss Fanny Cotton.
Fanny is concretely accessible.
We hardly have anything in common. Plus, she leaves piles of hair everywhere.
Who's that girl?
Fanny, it's over.
No! I'll always love you.
Have you started thinking of a scary story yet?
That girl is a psychopath. She got expelled from my high school for attacking students with her hairbrush.
With her hairbrush? Very funny. Listen, Fred, I've never had a problem with her, apart from her hair in the drain, the lake, and the cracks in the floor.
Mm-hmm. Hey there. My name's Fanny, but here at the camp, they call me Doughface. Welcome to the team. Your name is Fred, right? It's time for an excursion with my woodsy kitty friends. I'm so happy to see them again. See you later.
Mm-hmm. You two have never even met. You got me there, you kidder. If you're trying to convince me I made the right choice for storyteller, you're well on your way. Mm-hmm. Oh, it feels good to laugh.
Now, kids, let's make these expressive totem poles. Some faces filled with happiness and some filled with rage. For traumatized faces, we have a living model right here.
I told Hyacinth that Fanny's a psychopath that attacks people with a hairbrush, but she didn't believe it was true.
Mm-hmm.
I guess that did sound a little far-fetched, hmm?
And Fanny, how did she react?
She pretended not to know me.
If you want my advice, forget about it. She probably moved on to other things.
My totem represents the family I'll have when I grow up to be big and strong and virile like my brother.
We're leaving after this one, right?
Grow up. There's still three more. I thought you liked intestines.
No one is oblivious to indigestion caused by too much sudden evisceration, not even me. You see, I have a bit of my Aunt Aveline in me who, after eating three plates of tripe a la mode...
Forest.
It lived in the forest.
It was a little mushroom.
It was a little mushroom.
Was the ugliest in the west.
Was the ugliest in the west.
He will be eaten soon. The little mushroom.
All those in favor of Fred never singing again?
I'd like to say that the song was a special moment, but it's the kind of thing we like to instantly store in our repressed memories.
And now, the legend of the mutant swamp creature. It's believed that in the forest not far from here lives a creature of the marsh.
Oh, man, I'm shaking now.
Shush!
It is a dreadful creature with a cold stare. Covered with long, stringy hair like putrid-smelling seaweed.
Boof.
Every night, she goes looking for more victims to devour.
Boring.
And do you know who her favorite victims are?
Geeks.
Little campers like us.
Especially campers like Matthew.
Ugh, big whoop-de-whoop.
Oh, it's the creature of the marsh.
Oh, no, I miss Fred's scary story.
Barf. It wasn't nearly as scary as a song. Juliet, that name rings in my ears like a sizzling porterhouse steak.
Gaston George, sounds like a name you'd give a monkey.
Hmm.
want me to teach you how to paddle?
I'm not paddling, I'm fishing. If I could give you some advice.
If I could give myself advice, it would be not to listen to yours.
But why?
You have amnesia or what?
Yes. I'm suffering from a head trauma I got by falling down a flight of stairs. I have memory lapses. I don't even remember ever meeting you. You going out with the net?
No.
Oh, well.
Oh, that's gross!
Don't worry, I'll protect you from this boorish pestilate, this pest!
Oh, even more gross!
You see, that's what you have to do when you tell a scary story. You can't skimp on the costumes and special effects.
Come on, everyone, let's go back to camp.
During nighttime thunderstorms, the hideous marsh creature comes out of the forest. She stalks the campers and looks into their windows so she can choose her next victim.
I'm scared.
Please, I'm not that scared.
That was about as scary as a monorail ride. And your swamp creature been there, done that.
I'll give you 1.5 stars for effort.
What was that? The creature?
Fanny, I know you're out here. I knew it.
You knew what? What are you doing in my cabin?
You pretend not to remember, but you don't fool me. I know you're spying on me.
I don't know what you're talking about. And anyway, that diary's from when we were going out. It doesn't prove anything.
Ah, your memory's coming back to you.
It makes me happy that you came to see me as I brush my hair all alone in the dark.
Ah, gross! I have this strange feeling that someone is spying on me. I thought maybe it was Fanny, but now I'm not sure.
For several weeks now, every time I feel strange or troubling emotions, I write them down in my personal diary. The relief is simply immense. I just started working on volume 22.
Yeah, well, Fanny's personal diary is precisely what I want to get my hands on, so I can prove she never lost her memory.
And how goes everything with Annette?
Well, not bad so far. I'm actually happy that you signed me up.
I can assure you that as much as I'd like to take credit for playing Cupid, I wasn't the one who sent your CV to the camp.
If it wasn't you, who was it? I'm telling you, I don't like...
Relax. I'm only here to tell you that it's time for you to tell the kids another story. And I think that Annette is also waiting impatiently to hear it.
What's this? What? Too gross.
Fred. Fred!
Right away at the end of the path near the highway, I have to speak to you alone, Fred.
Do you like anchovies on your eggs in the morning?
Oh, you're gross. Miss Hyacinth, you won't stop bugging me.
Are you looking for Fanny also? She and Annette both missed breakfast. Maybe they don't like my boiled oats. I don't know why. It's always full of little lumps.
I'm going to find them. They couldn't have gotten too far.
Fabienne, I'm a little worried. Fanny Cotton is a counselor at Camp Woodsy Kitty Friends.
Fanny? The sexy psychopath?
One and the same. If she unleashes a psychotic fury on Fred, his ghost will be cooked!
Gigi, I have an idea. Instead of getting bored to death, why don't we hop in your car and embark on a mission to save Fred LeBlanc's butt?
coming between me and my little pumpkin. I'd rather you just disappear.
No! No!
I can't let you keep that, my sweet, adorable, one and only friend. It's an obstacle to our inevitable reconciliation. Freddy Boo!
What'd you do with the net?
She posed a serious threat to our relationship, my love. You don't think you can outbattle me in a canoe? Poor Freddy Boo.
Give me back my phone right now! Have you ever seen a man drop dead from asking for directions? It's ridiculous.
My virility is coming to question.
Gigi, I have to go to the bathroom really bad. Now stop being a moron or my foot will connect with your virility really hard, okay?
Oh.
Camp Woodsy Kitty friends, hello?
Hello. I'm a friend of Fred's. Could you direct me to...
I'm sorry, but this is a very bad time. I ruined my boiled oats, and to top it off, your friend disappeared into the forest with two female counselors.
Oh.
Give me back my diary. Why do you resist me, my love?
You make a list.
Give me back my diary. Everything I did, your application, the big CD, is because I'm crazy in love with you, Fred!
Moldy!
Oh. An outhouse! Hmm? Stop, Gigi! Huh? Explain it to me later!
Hey there, Renette!
Tell me what you did with the net!
Crow-faced girl will never get my man!
Benny! The diary! Moldy! Benny?
You are mine!
Get off me! You okay?
Ouch! Doesn't matter. Now my diary's gone. One day, I just know it, you'll be mine.
I think not. Did you guys find a net?
Did you guys find a net?
Ah, the monster from the Mars!
I am very proud of you, Fred LeBlanc. I had my doubts when I realized that you lied on your CV. I've been watching you all week. I didn't think you were very good, but now I can see where your talent lies. It's the first time a counselor has ever scared little Matthew, who's been coming here since he was 2 years old.
Best pal of mine!
You okay?
Yeah.
It's my brother, Gregory Gilbert. And her, she's Fred's friend, who never has a boyfriend, and I'll only know why when I grow up.
Gabriel Gideon.
Gaston George.
Oops.
Let's all call each other Gigi. It'll be less complicated.
I didn't find the girls, but I found this at the water's edge.
She locked me in the outhouse by the highway. If Fabienne hadn't miraculously showed up, I'd still be in there.
Fanny Doughface, I have a few questions to ask you.
Hmm?
yesterday, I wasn't really scared, but I felt you should be rewarded for your efforts. The costume was a nice touch.
3 stars?
2.
2.5?
Okay.
Okay.
I was afraid that the marsh monster had eaten you.
Adieu, Juliet. Matrimonial bliss and Mixmaster Turbo.
It was in the forest.
Sometimes, an X is like a horror story.